My name is Abby. I currently work for Field Ready, which is an organisation in Kathmandu trying to completely revolutionise humanitarian supply chains and delivering aid. The reason a lot of our work is centred on 3D printing at the moment is because a 3D printer is essentially a mobile factory. You can fit on the back of a motorcycle even, and I've just carried it down the street on quite a few occasions. The main ways we've used that, the biggest one has been in the medical sector. The way Nepal is it's a very mountainous country with just the worst roads, linking it up with all the other towns, cities and villages. It's a bit of a nightmare getting anything anywhere. The hospitals are not that connected to Kathmandu, which is where the airport comes in, which is where you get most of your supplies. So fixing medical equipment, there's such a big need for that right now. One of the hospitals we've been doing a lot of our medical objects with is a hospital in the Nuwakot district called Trishuli District Hospital.
Hello, Abby.
Oh, hi, how are you doing?
I'm fine, and you?
Yeah, pretty good. Long time no see.
Rather unfortunately, it was knocked down during the earthquake.
Now all those functional buildings were badly damaged, and now we are doing makeshift in tent.
It's incredibly challenging, I think, to be a doctor or a nurse trying to operate with failing equipment in a tent on a hill with virtually no resources. Being so remote, there isn't really any reason why they would easily be able to access sort of these really unique spare parts for quite novel pieces of equipment.
These services, they are very indispensable and they are very critical too. We can have those oxygen delivering machines. They are out of order sometimes. In that case, it can cost a patient's life.
One of the biggest things we've been doing is designing a new part to fit and printing out on the spot, which is really great because that's a perfect use of 3D printing. It's unique, bespoke parts created and made in remote locations where they're needed.
Abby told us all about those 3D printings, and we were not used to these kind of things, and we were quite surprised how it was going to work. And immediately she made that part, and after making that part I was able to work, and I was so happy.
3D printing is becoming quite a vital technology. This technology opens up the potential to have that same standard no matter where you are in the world. The long-term vision is to use this technology to 3D print people new bones for their legs and different new kneecaps. That's the long-term vision. So instead of feeling stumped because they can't get something or feeling stumped because it's very expensive in country, to be able to go, oh, I know, I can just go to these guys and get it made. Easy.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.